there's a whole lot going on in the shoulder girdle.
Yeah.
Some of which I think of specifically when I'm thinking about working with you.
Yeah.
To encourage you to take up the space that you can.
Okay.
Instead of trying to shrink down to people's size.
People's size.
You know what I mean?
I do.
All right. So, palms out to your sides once. When you roll your palms way the other way and keep going, see how your shoulder blades poke into the mat?
Yeah.
Well, as you roll your palms up, your shoulder blades anchor into your body, and that's meant to support your shoulder girdle.
Mm-hmm.
So keep your shoulders there and bring your arms down to your sides. And then when you turn your palms over and your fingers are together and thumb apart,
mm-hmm.
it gives you this line out through that,
mm-hmm.
push it out at me and down in your shoulders. Yes, that's your anchor for bringing your legs over your head.
Oh, okay.
Bring your legs in and up. Exhale your air. So up with air, stay there, and exhale and put your legs over your head. Open your legs shoulder width, press out your heels to come down. Then legs together, soft feet, inhale to come over. Now, balls of feet on the floor. Yes, if you can, that's as far as you would go, and you might press into the balls of your feet, heels pushing away from your head, and that's your contact back there. Now open your legs shoulder width. As you press out your heels, also keep curled around your ears on the roll down. Yes, yes. Legs together, pull it over. Open legs shoulder width, and it's ankles and ears to roll down. Now leave your legs open, pressing through your heels, this is harder. Bring your heels over your head. And then legs together, demi point, and now it's the metatarsals in your ears that are the two ends of the rubber band. Open your legs, press through your heels, bring it over. Legs together, balls of feet coming down, metatarsals and ears. Then one leg to the ceiling and one leg to the floor. Your left leg is ankle, top leg is metatarsal, and your bottom leg is right underneath you. So you would want to feel that as your position.
Okay.
Then inhale, stomach in, pull leg across. Start your exhale and circle around. Inhale and pull across, start your exhale, circle around. Yes. And then going the other way. Inhale first, stomach in, then get heavy to the side, start your exhale, and swoop across. Mm-hmm. Then bend that knee and give it a hug. Now everyone knows how to give it a hug, but if you put your hands easier on top of your shin,
mm-hmm.
and you push your leg against your hands, it relaxes the hip flexor and the quad that's doing all that work.
Oh, okay.
See what I mean?
Yeah.
Feel that?
Yeah. It's a different stretch.
Yeah, it's different, isn't it?
It is.
So there's technique and all this stuff, and you want to learn as much as you can from everybody.
Right.
Right?
Yeah.
So, switch legs. And if I say edges to you, I'm talking about the edges of your feet,
okay.
that you want them lifted so that you're standing on a flat surface.
Okay.
Okay? Inhale, stomach in, pull leg across. Start your exhale and circle around. Pin your shoulders. Yeah, that made a difference, didn't it? Mm-hmm. And then the other way, stomach first, and then gets heavy, starts to the outside, and exhale, come around. Mm-hmm. More weight down in the outside edges of your hands. Good, then bend that knee, give it the stretch you like, and then the stretch to do the press away. And that grip is what you use to roll up to sitting, to balance on your bottom for rolling like a ball. So reach on the outside of your legs. Try to, the words from old, place your head between your knees like a piece of wood in a carpenter's vise. So right here, knees.
Okay.
Squeeze them. Yes. Hands a hair lower. No, way too much. Good. Inhale, rock back and come back up, trying to hold that position. Atta girl, good. Feel your legs. Well, you lost that feeling of legs pushing against your hands.
Yeah.
And that killed it.
Yeah.
Try it again. Exhale sooner. Good.